My name is Charles Baudelaire. I am a poet, a great French poet who in my time was not recognized. In your time, my poetry was hailed as classic, but not me. I speak a ghastly language called English. Every French word I had in me has been bled away. All I remember of my writing is a silly little book about evil flowers, or some such crap. I was disgruntled, disgusted, sick with alcohol and drugs, and yet something happened. It truly did. I will try to narrate the unimaginable. When I consider the brief span of my life absorbed into the eternity which comes before and after, the small space I occupy and which I see swallowed up in the infinite immensity of spaces of which I know nothing and which know nothing of me, I am amazed to see myself here rather than there. There is no reason for me to be here rather than there, now rather than then. Who put me here? By whose command and act were this place and time allotted to me?
Thank you.
In this modern age, so fast and loud, I, Baudelaire, wander lost and forlorn, where beauty fades and sorrows abound. In the heart of a world, callous and torn, the streets, once adorned in poetic grace, now echo with shallow mechanical beat. No longer do souls commune in embrace, but exist as shadows, in solitude complete. Curse of progress, relentless and cold, where screens replace the human touch, empty pursuits, like fool's gold, leave hearts empty, yearning for so much. The ancient poets, their voices I miss, their verses danced, a symphony divine, but now, their words drowned in a sea of abyss. In this soulless era, I struggle to find where is the art that moves and inspires, that stirs the depths of a languid soul. Lost in a world of instant desires, where cheap thrills take their illusory toll. The masks we wear, an insidious masquerade, to fit into this facade of false delight, but beneath the surface, darkness pervades, longing for meaning, for truth in the night. I am bound to this time and place, where progress marches, relentless and cruel, yet within my heart, a flickering trace, a flame of rebellion, a poetic fuel. I shall write, in defiance and despair, words that resonate, even in this sterile land. For within the depths of my poetic lair, I'll keep the flame alive with my trembling hand. I lament and mourn, the loss of a world, once tender and true, yet in my verses, a glimpse of hope is born.
We meet anew, two souls entwined, by fate's whimsical hand. Falling into love's intoxicating brew, hope blooming like flowers in an enchanted land. Despair and joy, like shadows and light, dancing a delicate waltz, hand in hand, moments of enchantment, in each other's sight, a symphony of hearts, in a foreign land. The strangeness of love, a beautiful haze, as we unravel mysteries, undiscovered, enchanted by the depths, in passionate blaze, in each other's arms, we feel recovered.
But alas, disenchantment sneaks its way, unveiling cracks, beneath the surface gleam. Discovery reveals truths we cannot sway, and loss creeps in, shattering our dream.
Yet let us cherish that dance, sweet and bold, for love's ephemeral beauty, we must adore, in this spirit, our story unfolds, a tapestry of love, forevermore.
Thank you.
In the darkness of my longing, she appears. Delia, the temptress who ignites my fears. A sensuous allure, a wicked charade, a siren in this senseless world, where I'm betrayed. Let us revel in our darkness, in our sin, for the modern world's cruelty is a battle we cannot win. Delia, my rapturous courtesan, I am yours to keep, in your arms, I find solace, I find sleep.
You know, Monsieur Baudelaire, there's more to your beloved Delia than meets the eye. She's a muse, but not just any muse. She's a mercenary muse, an angel in hell.
Bartender, how dare you?
Delia's gift, though born from darkness, brings solace to many through her poetic endeavors. You see, Delia has the unique ability to extract inspiration from the depths of despair, from the darkest corners of this tumultuous world. She thrives amidst chaos and anguish, her beauty and grace, acting as a beacon for troubled souls.
So, you're saying she feeds off the suffering of others? That her inspiration comes from their pain?
Indeed. It's a delicate balance. Delia, like an angel, carries the burden of others' anguish, channeling their suffering into poetic fervor.
I have always been drawn to the shadows, to the realms of the tormented. Perhaps she and I are kindred spirits, destined to dance within the flames of inspiration. Is it not a cruel fate to be bound to such a role? To thrive in a world of despair and chaos?
Perhaps, Monsieur Baudelaire, but remember, it is in the depths of darkness that true art often flourishes. And in those depths, she feeds off of you.
No. I refuse to accept this. I'm leaving this wretched city, this cursed world of iniquity. Delia or no Delia, I'll seek solace elsewhere. the liar. I had to leave.
Yet here we stand.
All is behind me. Dreams, poetry, my age, gone. Without reason.
Not our love.
Do you think so? We merge together.
We cannot go on. We cannot go back.
Look what time does to us.
Not our love.
Extraordinary that which was so mysterious should be so absurd.
Our sand will mingle forever.
Forever. I could not tell you why.